Root 1, non-operative management. Just like everyone has unique physical qualities and attributes, so does an individual's curve. As a result, there is not a one-size-fits-all solution. Scoliosis can be treated non-operatively or operatively, without surgery or with surgery, and is determined based on the size and severity of your curve. Non-operative treatment options are primarily focused on the size of the curve and amount of growth remaining. For instance, curves between 10 to 25 degrees are considered mild. At this stage, observation is recommended if the patient is still growing. Observation includes visits to a specialist where they will monitor your curve by taking periodic x-rays of your spine. If the patient is no longer growing, no treatment is necessary. Moderate curves are between 25 and 40 degrees. At this stage, patients are recommended to wear a brace. For those no longer growing, observation over the course of 3 to 5 years is the recommended treatment option. Curves greater than 50 degrees are considered severe. At this stage, surgery is recommended for patients whether they are still growing or not. Operative treatment will be discussed more in Chapter 4. In this chapter, we will be discussing bracing as a non-operative treatment option. What is bracing? Bracing is conducted by a bracing specialist, an orthotist, who will evaluate, design, and fit an external support system, or a brace, in an attempt to halt abnormal curves in the spine. How does bracing work? The typical scoliosis brace is made of contoured plastic that fits snugly around the torso and hips. There are a variety of brace styles, some designed to be worn full-time and others to be worn only at night. The biomechanical principles of bracing are founded on evidence that directed pressure reduces the curves and moves the spine into better alignment while the brace is worn. One common question among patients is whether scoliosis bracing is effective. Plainly put, bracing is effective, but occasionally it is not. Research has shown a 72% success rate in stopping the curve progression for patients who consistently wore a brace versus a 48% success rate for patients who did not wear a brace. The same research study concluded 18 hours or more per day is the optimal amount of time needed to halt curve progression. Ultimately, this means that people who consistently wear a brace are less likely to develop a curve that may require surgery. Bracing is proven to be the most effective non-operative treatment option. Are there other treatment options that will prevent scoliosis from worsening? This is a topic of great debate. Proponents claim a variety of treatments and techniques can prevent scoliosis progression, including acupuncture and acupressure, electrical stimulation, biofeedback, traditional physical therapy, magnets, Scroth physical therapy, chiropractic manipulation, shoe orthotics, and other less traditional treatments. However, currently none of these methods have evidence to prove their claims. Ultimately, it is the responsibility of the patient, parent, and the physician to determine the best course of action and treatment method. The treatment approach should be based on many factors, including the degree of curvature, amount of growth remaining, and the patient's willingness to adhere to the bracing program. If bracing is chosen, open communication between the patient, parent, physician, and orthotist is essential to achieving success. For more information about bracing, visit our website at www.settingscoliosisstraight.org and download our free scoliosis handbook today. We hope that you have a little better understanding on bracing. So now let's move on to Chapter 4. Chapter 4 will address operative treatment and additional information about surgical intervention.